a good idea to know your family history. So there is something called Dupuytren's contracture. So that's when there's like a tendon in the hand that starts to bunch up. And often men can look at their father's hands and see whether or not there's any of this Dupuytren's type of trigger-like finger appearance. And there's a 40% correlation if men have this, that they might acquire Peyronie's disease. So there's a little bit of a nervous discussion at times from one generation to the other. So just know your genetic background, because it's meant to be a condition of being genetically predisposed to this. There's also just general cardiovascular health. And if there's any changes to the quality of erection, or there starts to be any pain or any physical changes, there could also be an indicative change of cardiovascular problems or heart problems. So you might have heard me say the phrase, your heart health and your heart health are related. So we do need to be mindful that our cardiovascular health is a mirror to our sexual function and sexual function to our heart health. So we can get something called the coronary calcium scores these days, which can give us a bit of indication of what calcium levels we might have. And the blood vessels to the penis are about 1 millimeter, whereas the blood vessels to the heart are about 4 to 6 millimeters. So if you've got changes in the penis, it could be a reflection of changes to the major heart blood vessels, just not being able to shunt blood to the extremities as well. So general health is really important. I also think pelvic floor exercises can be a really good way of just improving local blood flow. And in actual fact, there's a body of my patients that probably have a tight pelvic floor. And in that case, they haven't had trauma. They haven't had Peyronie's come on from surgery or radiation therapies. And with that, the tightness of the pelvic floor is not letting the blood flow freely as well. So sometimes they might have pain with erections or pain with orgasm, and then also Peyronie's disease. And often they'll need physiotherapy to actually manage the pelvic floor tightness or hypertonicity. And that's a pelvic floor therapist that teaches a lot of relaxed type breathing and relaxation of the pelvic floor and yoga based techniques. So there's actually lots and lots of different things that you can do to work with Peyronie's and its improvement.
Am I right in thinking if somebody has a tight pelvic floor, that in itself actually could, did you say it could actually be potentially one of the causes?
I would say to you at the moment that that's just what we observe clinically and anecdotally. It's not really a published paper or anything just at the moment. However, we do know that only 40% of the time have we got an explanation for Peyronie's occurring. So the other 60% has to come from somewhere. And I'd say about 20% of my patients fit that criteria of having a tight pelvic floor. There are some guys who've had back injuries as well, and there might be some corresponding osteoarthritic changes in their spine, or they might be very inactive with stiff backs and they just consequently get stiff hamstrings, stiff pelvic floors, stiff adductor muscles, and so you can definitely work on those. But look, it's difficult to diagnose everything, and it's difficult to produce research. But one of the four foremost papers that I rely on is always one by a lady called Debbie Cohen. And she talks about the impact of male pelvic floor muscle function on sexual function, and that there's something called chronic pelvic pain syndromes. And she was able to show that if you have tight pelvic floor muscles, that can impact on something called the internal pudendal artery. And that is the artery that supplies the pelvic floor, that supplies the penis. And so subsequent erectile dysfunction, and in my case studies, in my clinical work, we've been able to see Peyronie's develop and then go and have a look at Doppler scans and see that those two things equate. But it's kind of an emerging body of evidence, I guess.